I'm not ashamed of being white. I'm just white. That's the way it is.
You're a woman of the colour white.
That's the one.
Yo, what's up? It's Church, one half of Church and AP, the best rap group in the world. And I know nothing about politics, but lucky for me, I'm a first-time voter, so I'm about to have a date with Judith Collins.
Hello. Judith Collins. Hi, how are you?
We'll give you a little bump. Elbow and a West Auckland eyebrow.
And I'll do you one of mine.
The first thing I wanted to ask you was, you know, as a politician, your whole life is kind of under a microscope. Anything that you say or wear can be used against you.
Oh, you're so right. You know my life.
Yeah. How are you able to balance your mental health, both publicly for National and privately for your family?
What I do is that, because I like being online, mm-hmm. I just mute them,
right.
I delete them, I ban them.
Block them?
I block them. It's good to have a laugh.
Yeah.
I don't mind laughing. People laugh at
you
me
laugh
all the time.
At the memes that,
I
you
laugh
see
at
sometimes?
The memes at me.
Increasingly it seems, and especially while I was at school, cyberbullying was a big issue. And in the developed world, New Zealand has the second highest rate of youth suicide.
Yeah.
What can National do to help that?
We brought in the Harmful Digital Communications Act.
Yeah, right.
And we did that for that very reason. And because it struck me that there were a lot of, particularly young people, who had a whole spate of youth suicides, and quite a lot of it seemed to be directed or coming from really online cyberbullying.
I read in your memoirs that you were a farm girl.
Yeah.
So can you tell me a bit about your family growing up in the housing situation?
Our house was, it had been built in about early 1950s. I realise now that it was really cold.
Yeah.
A lot. So we had five kids, two parents, and I now look back and think, wow, you know, it wasn't flash, but I tell you what, it was home.
Under National's last term of government, you built roughly 1,500 state houses, but sold 1,300, and you've said that was a mistake, so how do you fix it?
Actually build more social housing. Even some of the housing that's been built since under the current government, that's the state housing. A lot of that was consented and planned under National, but it takes ages to get stuff done. Housing is really important. It's really hard if you are trying, you know, how do you do your homework if you don't have a house to do it in?
Let's talk about inequality.
Yeah.
When did you first realise you had white privilege?
I guess when I realised I heard people talking to me about people who weren't white, and I realised that they didn't realise that actually it's really hard sometimes to be taken seriously. You know, my husband's Samoan, and hearing the way that he takes racial abuse all the time, I find that really disturbing. As no one looks at me and say, well, maybe they do because I'm a woman, but you know, people don't look at me and say, well, you know, she can't achieve X. You know, and as a Samoan man, he gets a lot of bias against him from people who think that he should be somehow see his place in the world as being less than it is. There's the odd, particularly of the left, frankly, who are very white, who sit there and look at him and say, well, you're brown, why aren't you Labour?
Right.
Or why should he be? Shouldn't he be who he is?
You know, a quarter of Māori and Pacific are brought into material hardships and don't have, you know, adequate resources or essentials to buy and can't get fresh fruit or veggies and end up having to, you know, get what's easiest, and what's really around them is fast food, and that all leading contributing factors to heart disease and diabetes within our communities.
Yeah, and you know what? Who are you going to listen to? Who are you personally going to listen to?
Someone who I feel is
connection to you, connected to you.
Yeah.
Yeah. So it is natural for people, in my opinion, to want to see their face reflected back at them.
Do you think that you, well, National, understand the plight of Samoans or the Māori and Pacifica better than the left?
Well, actually, someone like my husband lives it.
Right.
And we've been together for 41 years. What do you think?
In 42 years, I will be your age. Do you think that we'll have the COVID debt sussed by then?
We should, if we borrow to invest. So if we borrow to invest, yes we can. And the way that we pay back debt, is not by taxing people. The way you pay back debt is actually by growing the economy. We're borrowing $500 million mm-hmm. every week to pay the wage subsidy. So for instance, that $500 million that we're borrowing at the moment just for the wage subsidy, you know what? That builds a whole new hospital, like a big public hospital. So every week at the moment, over the last few months, our country has borrowed enough money for 50 big
public hospitals.
So the thing is, we've got to have a plan to get people into work building those hospitals, getting to work building the schools, so that yes, the money's going into people, but it's going in for them to work. Work is, and I absolutely believe this with everything in me, and it is, my life is all of this, is work is a wonderful thing. So even things that are a bit mundane, you can make them fun,
right.
You know?
What's the most you've ever borrowed?
Lots, hundreds of thousands of dollars for a house.
Mm-hmm. Now,
yep.
A quick game of yeah, nah. Are you going to tax more?
Nah.
Would you win in a physical fight against Dr. Ashley Bloomfield?
Yeah.
Do you think Paul McCartney is the best Beatle?
Yeah.
Are you going to vote yes to legalising weed?
No.
Would you feature on a rap song with me?
Yeah.
And why should I vote for you?
Because I'm the best.
Thank you so much, Judith Collins, for coming in and spending some time with me. You are the most well-dressed politician I've seen in person. Can we get a close-up? If you can just show us your bling.
Yeah,
this is very important.
I just felt like a bit of bling today.
Uh-huh, yeah. Just go like this. So this is what we call the drip.
What? Oh, this, yeah.
Mm-hmm. And then show the watch.
Oh, then the watch, yeah.
We're gonna like overlay some rap music on this in 3, 2, 1, boom. So just, mm-hmm.
You just need a little bit of the bling?
Yeah, just a bit of the bling.
Yeah. Next thing will get me going some more, and I'll be doing this next.
Oh, then it's a SIBA.
SIBA, yeah. Then you'll be wanting to put money on me.
Ooh, 60K. Boom.
That's it. Boom.
It's the Simone guy. He bought it all.
Nephew's Joseph Parker.
Oh,
you know.
She says it's my guy.
Last.
Joseph Parker.
It's my nephew.
Ooh.
Yes, I'm his auntie, dude.
Brilliant.
That was probably the buzziest experience I've had in a while. Kind of talking to a politician is like a weird experience where like you ask them something and it feels like they ask you something. I feel like she definitely pandered to me a little bit. She brought up Joseph Parker being her nephew, which is cool. I like Joseph Parker, but I know this one famous Samoan guy. Do you know him as well? Of course I know Joseph Parker, I love Joseph Parker. You know, those National guys are human. From what I've heard about National growing up, is that they're these big figures that peer over my neighborhoods and take joy away. But Judith Collins made me laugh a couple times. She admitted to having white privilege. That's a win for us.